Have you ever wondered on your Java application to add a browser that looks exactly like Google Chrome? Well, now you can using something called GX Browser developed by Team Dev, and it is not free, but you can get an open source license or you can test it by yourself for 30 days to see how it goes. It is based on Chromium 60. And this will be like a basic tutorial on how to set it up on your own on Eclipse. And by the way, I will also create a repository of this browser on GitHub. You can find it right here, JavaFX Chromium Browser Basic Tutorial. I will post the links below the video. So let's go here. What we need to do first of all. Let's go on licensing and pricing. So, as you can see here, you can get a license for commercial project if you want. I will go here. And what we need is an open source license, or we will evaluate for 30 days our own license. So you go here, I will post the link below the video, and you fill these things, and then in your email you get something like this. So you go download evaluation license, and I will save it on the browser. Very well, very well. So now let's go here on the website. All right, so I will go on documentation. So now we need to install it on Eclipse, right? When you will download actually this repository from GitHub, you will have everything set up. But I want you and I now to go together to see how you can build it from scratch. So it is very, very easy, by the way. I will provide you all the code. So this is a Maven project, and we need to add now the dependencies. This is a cross-platform browser, but of course you have to add for Windows dependencies, macOS, Linux, or you have to adjust this and it will download all the dependencies. I will show you now for Windows, and you can use whatever you want. So first thing you have to do is go here on repository and add this repository here. As you can see, I have added Team Dev products Maven repository, and then we will add this dependency for Windows. You can add this, and the code will be exactly the same. All right, the code will be exactly the same. So for this tutorial, I'm just using Windows here, and I will copy paste Windows here, and the project is being built by Maven. It will let me cancel this. We need the latest version, which is 19 point. Let me see which is the latest version. I think it is 19, 6.19.1. 6.19.1. Okay, I have already downloaded it with Maven, so it will not take time for me here. So let's go straight here. Okay, so now I will go again, and on tutorial here, by the way, I'm on documentation section, and here on documentation you can find like everything. You can build a new whole browser from scratch just by reading all these tutorials. I think it will take you like 1 week, but you will find out. So let's go here and create a browser instance. We go here and create a browser instance. Let's add it here and import. And we need a browser view. Where it is. Let's go here on documentation and search for JavaFX tutorial getting start guys. Guide for JavaFX developers. So here we are. Add libraries. Yes. So this is for JavaFX developers, and as you can see for macOS on the init of the application, it has something special, some more lines here, as you can see, and you can add them. But now we are on Windows, we don't use them. You know what? I will add them because you may say me, hey Alex, why you don't add for Mac? Okay, look, I have added that. Okay, so now be happy. And what we need here is I will like copy paste the code here, and I will paste it here. I will keep this thing here, and primary stage. Okay, Control Shift F, organize a little bit the code. I need this line here. I will tell you why, because we need to dispose the browser on application exit. So Control Shift O for imports. Yes, so very well, very well. Let me see, let me see. Here we have a problem. I will show you why. This, by the way, is a class which will make your life way lot easier, and I have made this for you because GX browser requires to dispose the browser in a different way based on your operating system. But don't worry about it, I have made everything ready for you. So I will go here and run it to check how it goes on, and guess what, look here, GX browser license check failed, no valid license found. Yes sir. So now let's add the license. We go here, and here is the license. Copy and paste it. You can create a folder name libraries, but I will just paste it like here in the repository because I don't care. It's easy, by the way. So go here, GRI system library, right click, so add it on the build path. If you are on NetBeans or Intel Gia, you know the way, it's very similar. Just add it on the path, license, apply and close. So now we run it, and you can see the license is valid. But what is this wide window? We want to load YouTube. Yes, we want. Let's go here on the start guide, and let me open a new private window, and I will load youtube.com. I will take the link from here, and I will go back in Eclipse. So browser dot load URL, where it is, you see that? Yeah, here it is, load URL. By the way, you see I'm doing things like I'm not using try catch and things like this. In a real application, you have to do it. Okay, so I go here, run it. What's the problem? Oh, yes, yes, yes. So now I will tell you what I have done. I just restarted Eclipse because I couldn't find the Java background application running. So what was the problem this time? When you open GX browser and you don't dispose the browsers here, it causes a deadlock to the application when you open it again. So you have to dispose the browser correctly. So now I have added all the code. When you close the application from here, it goes util.terminate application. And based on your operating system, if it is on Windows, it is disposing on a different thread. If it is on Mac and Linux, it is disposing the browser on a JavaFX thread. Also, I have done something more here I want to show you. So when you run the GX browser, actually, it has to go. I will go on Maven dependencies for you. As you can see, here is GX browser original code, and here it is GX browser for Windows, the jar file. So it goes and extracts this to a folder. Usually this on the Windows is the user data folder, but now I have changed it, and as you can see here, it goes on the current folder of the application, and it creates a new folder named Chromium, and inside that folder it extracts all the file. So you may ask me why this is important. I will show you. Let's firstly go here and source main java.com. So somewhere here it creates this folder named Chromium. So let's actually see why I don't see this folder here. Maybe it's on target. Where it is? Why I don't see this? Here it is. You can see Maven goes here, so it goes Chromium, and you can see all the extracted files here for Windows. If you are on Mac, it will extract them here. If you are on Linux, here. So I'm doing this because sometimes your Java application may not be allowed to extract the files into the default folder that GX browser has. I will not go more deep into that. I wanted just to say you this thing to know. Okay, so now I will run the application. As you can see, we have opened YouTube, and don't close it from here because you have to restart Eclipse. Just close it from here. Okay, so very, very well. You can see I will start it again. So we have YouTube fully. As you can see, it even has my channel here. I can go to the channel. You can see here, if I go on the first page, Coach Corey teaching for how to get a woman. In case you don't know him, he's amazing. And I will close this. So let me think what I may not have told you. Basically, this is the things you have to know when you start with this. Oh yes. When now you extract this browser, this application, your application is not gonna work because you need to add the license on the meta-inf folder of your application. So how you do that actually? So now I will show you when you export your JavaFX application based on GX Chromium browser, how to make it runnable. On other words, how to add the license to it. So let's go here, and I will open a terminal. So I will run a Maven clean package to build the application. And as you can see here, I have added everything for you: the assembly, XML, and in the POM, the required plugins. So everything is ready for you. You will just download the repository and check it for yourself. So here on the target now, it has created, as I have said and defined on it, the jar files and bins folders and other things. So we need here the library folder and the runnable jar file. So I'm copying. I'm pressing Ctrl C, okay? So I go on desktop now. What is happening? I'm going on desktop, and I will do a paste here. So as you can see, we have the library and the runnable jar file. But look here, if I go and open the command prompt, I will do Java. Look which version I have. I have Java 8, okay? Java jar, the starting letter, JavaFX, okay, enter. Look here, yes, it is saying that the license is not correct and things like that. So now we have downloaded the license jar from before, as I have shown you. You go here on meta-inf and you just drag and drop it here. So we need this license. This is actually, will go here on the jar file. So right click, open archive, go on meta-inf, drag and drop this thing here and close it. Now go rerun. You can see it runs perfectly. I want to say you one more thing here. As you can see in XRP player, I'm doing the same thing also in the exe files. If you open them as an archive, you can see I have the license here. Okay, so this is it, how you make the runnable to run without the error of the license. So let's go back in the Eclipse now. What I have not said to you, let me think. That's pretty much it, the basic stuff. So you will go and clone the repository from GitHub, importing the Eclipse, and there you go, bros.